back to Grassroots Media. Welcome back to this year's edition of the Baileyton Drug Company TMB Show presented by Starne's Barbershop. As always, I'm here with Huskies head coach Sam Tarlton and Lady Huskies head coach James Buchanan. Fellas, how are we doing today?
Is our commercial going to be on later?
Your commercial?
Have you not seen it yet?
I haven't seen it. No, I haven't.
I'll pull it up right now.
Pull it up and show it to him. Robert Starnes, he cut my hair. Kinda.
he really gave me one.
He moved the shaving cream off my head.
Oh, okay.
And then he really gave Sam a haircut.
This is an A. Look at this. A plus right here.
You're in, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm in it. I mean, it's, you just said that our show is brought to you by
Starne. Lifelong resident of
Northern Greene County. Look at that onion he's peeling.
Look at that shine, too.
Yeah, you got those balls.
You know why it shines?
It looks good.
See, angels and things like that, they're in this dimension you can't really see, but sometimes the halo, there's a reflection of my halo. There we are on the bench.
Pretty good.
I'll probably be in here.
Can you ever going to go see Starne? Robert?
I might have to.
You know where you look like you need
looks
it.
Like it's
I got one scheduled tomorrow. I got one
where?
It's not with Starnes.
Who's your bar?
Cancel it. Go see Robert.
Yeah.
I would, but I can't. I got to be loyal.
Loyal to somebody that sponsors Grassroots?
Who? Yeah.
I could, but
who
I
does your look, does your barber sponsor Grassroots?
He doesn't.
Well, it's time to switch.
Scheduled it on Monday. Came in here on Tuesday.
Hey, with Robert, you don't even have to schedule. You just walk
You just
out
show
here.
Up.
Yeah.
All this driving. Man's got all kinds of stuff going on over there. Let me highly recommend Robert Starnes.
Yep.
For all your barber needs. And who? Baileyton Drug?
What do you call your haircut?
What do I call my
haircut? What's the name of it?
I walk in there and he's like, same thing as last time? I'm like, yep.
Same thing as last time.
Same thing as last time.
We've got some boys. I didn't know this. I'm learning some stuff. We got a boy that's going with the burst fade.
Yep.
The worst
fade. Robert can do the burst fade.
Right here. You start right here. Pretty much just...
You just shave it.
Around your ear.
And then it bursts in the hair.
Burst in the hair. Burst fade.
Okay. I'd never heard
of it.
Probably
look good on
you. I would look good on you. I think you need...
I've been told I need to switch something up. What do you recommend?
Go in there tomorrow and tell whoever your loser barber is, as compared to Robert Starnes, that you need a burst fade.
Burst fade.
If they say, I don't know what that is, turn around and walk out.
You already got
what if it looks bad?
It won't look bad.
No, you rock anything.
Look at
you
Sam.
Sure?
If it don't look bad on Sam.
I ain't seen Sam yet.
Go in there and tell him high and tight. You know what that is.
I do.
Go in there and tell him.
All right.
Who are going high and tight?
Baileyton Drug.
Oh, let me put a plug in for Baileyton Drug. I didn't even know this stuff happened now. Last school year, I'm sick.
Oh, yeah.
My wife,
that was awesome.
My wife works here. So she said, you know you can do one of these, what do you call them, Sam? Telehealth.
Yeah, telehealth, that's it.
So I get on there and I meet some doctor I've never seen in my life. Now, our school nurse, Debbie Charlton, by the way, she's top of the line.
Her husband made this...
This stool right here that y'all probably can't see, that the microphone's sitting on. Gary made that for us. You talk about great people in this community. The Starnes, you got barbers, you got carpenters, you've got drug dealers. I'm talking about the Baileyton.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Come on, man. So I get on this telehealth thing. Debbie's already done my blood pressure, checked my temperature. This lady comes on the screen, asks me what my symptoms are. I tell her. She calls me in some medicine. I go over to the, you guessed it,
drugstore.
Baileyton drugstore. It was ready when I got there. Started feeling better. I mean, like almost immediately. So between the Baileyton drugstore and Robert Starnes' barbershop, we've got it
covered.
We got it covered in here.
We did an interview that day last year too.
Yeah.
I was impressed you finished the interview too. I don't think anybody knew you were sick. Well, you mentioned it like first thing.
Yeah, we had.
Because you had to tell the amazing experience.
You got to step up.
This is flu show.
Yeah. It's like Jordan. Carried him off the court. He'd give everything. I gave him my best. Season premiere.
Was it food poisoning?
I don't know what he had. Oh, you're talking about
he food poisoning. Poison.
He claims food poisoning.
He didn't have nothing. He didn't have nothing. He needed more like narrative to the goat story.
Yeah.
He might have had. Who knows?
Is it your goat?
I don't know.
I can't answer that question either. I had somebody ask me that the other day. I don't know who.
Hey, you know what?
I think it's always LeBron and Jordan.
Here's how you know it's Jordan. I have not liked both of them. You know, when LeBron was in Miami, you know, everybody hated him. Well, now he plays for the Lakers, so I like him. He's on my favorite team now. But Jordan, I never did like his teams. I was always pulling for whoever they played against. Here's how you know who the best is. When you're pulling against them, and they just keep winning to the point where you just have to tap out and say, okay, you're the man. Mm-hmm. I never could do that with LeBron.
That's Tom Brady, too.
Mm-hmm. Tom, same when way. When Tom went to pull Tampa, against him, he wins anyway.
There, Jeter.
Nobody said anything about this being our season premiere.
It is.
Season 3.
Season 3.
Who? What show, Tyler, since I don't have social media, maybe you can remind the viewers. Who had the most views or who won show of the year after season 1?
You are the 2-time back-to-back.
So you're saying season 1 and 2?
Yes, sir.
Okay, because I didn't know. And I forgot about the award show. You know what I was doing the day of your award show this last year? You know, 2 years ago, y'all scheduled Father's Day.
Yeah, I knew what you were doing 2 years ago.
Father's Day 2 years ago. And then this past year, Sam texts me, you going to that show tonight? Where was it at? I've had some former players get married at this place. Wait a minute. Do they sponsor Grassroots?
They don't. I can't remember the name of it.
Johnson.
The home place.
Johnson Farm, home place.
Yeah, something like that.
Okay. They're having this award show. Sam texted me, and I was right in the middle mowing my yard. I forgot.
Nice.
And there was no way I could get cleaned up by then. There was no way. I had no way.
I didn't go either.
No chance.
That's all right.
It's all right.
I'll tell you what.
If we win it this year,
we're going to be there.
You got to be there for the
win three-peat. Win or lose, we're going
to
be there.
You got to be there for the three-peat.
We'll be there to crown the new king, whoever it is, or we'll be there to accept our back-to-back-to-back championship.
Might have a few award winners from North Greene, too. You had a few last year.
Who?
I'd have to go
through. Did we win team of the year? We should have got something for that.
I could go through.
Is there even a thing, team of the year?
Team of the year, there was.
Really?
There was.
Probably gave it to you.
Well, how did we not get it?
There wasn't like a basketball. I think it was an overall team of the year.
I don't care.
Who got that?
See, Roots.
Wait a minute. Somebody probably won a state championship last year, didn't they?
Greenville Baseball.
Yep.
Did they get
baseball won team of the year.
Okay. All right.
That's fair.
Coach of show of the year.
We will acknowledge them. State champs, we acknowledge them.
Basketball, male player of the year. Jason
won that. You think he's going back to back?
Softball player of the year, Campbell Gaby.
All right.
Pitcher of the year, Campbell Gaby. She swept the softball awards.
Campbell's the GOAT. Who we got? Who's your early picks for?
Wait a minute. What other awards are there?
You want me to read them all?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, I don't know the categories.
All right. There's about 33. So
is there? No. Never mind. I don't want to do that. Is there a game of the year? Like the game of the year. Well, how was it not our
I nominated you all.
Well, how you were nominated. Who won?
Greenville versus Upperman State Championship game.
What sport?
Baseball.
Oh, okay.
Was it good?
It was. It was a 1-0 pitcher's duel.
Oh, well.
And they put runners on second and
how
third.
How many were nominated? If we were like top three, I can see that. What a game that was.
There were five. It was Chucky Doe versus Unicoi County Football.
Greenville and
Upperman State Championship Baseball.
Okay.
South Greene, West Greene, the Milk Can game.
Is that Substate. Close?
Yeah. West Greene had to come from behind and then ended it on an interception.
Coach, what's the best game you've ever been a part of?
That one has to rank up there pretty high. I don't think anybody saw it come. There was a rival coach, no joke, and a real close friend of mine, a school in our conference. He called me 2 or 3 weeks when the season was over with. We was making plans for this coming year, you know, camps and all that. And he came to my camp. He said, I'm just going to tell you, I figured you'd lose that game by 20. He said, I played Oneida in the off season, and when I saw you had to go there and play with all the injuries and stuff you had, there was no way I thought you'd win that game. He said, I saw that score, and I thought it was a misprint.
You must not have seen all these balls up here in this office. Look at that.
You need to tell him to come in the office next time.
I need to take his stuff throw away.
Why? Hey, did you know, Coach, he deserves a congratulations. He got another award right over here the other day. A.F. Bridges, Athletic Director of the Year.
Dipstick I saw award. That. I
he's
saw
goat.
That.
Man, he's Athletic Director
saw that
of the
on
Year.
The
Coach of the Year.
Athletic Director of the Year. What a joke. I'm the Athletic Secretary. I get their schedules and the eligibility online. I make sure all of our coaches go to the rules meeting so we don't get fined.
That's what an athletic director
does. That's the criteria. Then, hey, there's hope for all of you out there, ADs.
I'm trying to think. I don't know of any other games that would top that by you.
I'd have to think on it.
We had a crazy one my first year in here. That's my number one game. Sub-state.
Caulfield.
Yeah.
There's two games that from the same season, believe it or not. When we finished state runner-up in 2011, we came back 2012, and one of our top players, all-state player, Mariah Britton, had graduated. And then Mindy McNeese, our top returning player, who was a sophomore that year, blew out her knee. So, I mean, you talk about everybody writing us off that year. It's kind of like last year's team. Mm-hmm. We had two wins that year that we had no business winning. One was in here against Greenville, and then one was at Chucky Doak. And that was a sub-state Chucky Doak team. They had Carly Fry, had a really good team. And I can't think that anybody in their right mind would have thought we would have won either one of those games. And that was a special crew. Those were fun games. There's been a lot of them, though. That just means I've been here for ever.
23rd year.
This starts
really?
Starting Jordan number 23.
This is Jordan year.
I think I've coached in. It's getting close to 800 games.
Wow.
It's 700 and something.
So you got an over 50%. You got an over 500 record.
Yeah. Oh, we hope so. This man. Yeah. He's been goat.
I look up there every time we do a show and see the wins. What year did you start?
2001, 2002 was the first year.
Look at that.
How old were you, Tyler?
Let's talk about Sam.
01, 02?
Huh? That's when you were born?
2 or 3. No. I was born in 99.
99.
Yeah. Just a little
so you were in diapers still.
Took you about 7-8 years to get 100 wins. And then since then, 12 years later, you got over 300.
The first few years, hey, I hope some of them kids watch this show.
Once he got it in a row.
They laid the foundation. We didn't win many games, but they laid the foundation.
Look at that.
Hey, you want to talk
about... Start 01, 02. Hey. Took you 8 years to get 100. Then it took 4 to get another, 5 to get another, and 3 to get another. You're closing in on 500.
Actually,
soon
it just took
be.
About 4 because that was in January. It just flipped to the new year. It was like 4 years and 2 months. Not 5 years. It didn't take 5 years.
Which one are you talking about?
From between 2 and 3. Look right there between 3 and 4, though. Now, that's when them studs come rolling through here.
3 years.
Yeah, it didn't take long.
3 years.
Let's talk about the most successful man in North Greene history. Right over there. This man's win percentage is higher than anybody's. Hey, look at it. Figure that up.
Is it over
75? Coaches' win percentages in Greene County in the last 50 years.
Do you have a record book?
No.
Need to make one.
I'm making one.
He's got something.
That's what I'm saying.
I'm figuring all that out. Oh, it ain't even close.
What is mine?
Like hey, you want to know the cold, hard truth, viewers?
Oh, God.
This is cold and it's hard, but it's just the truth. Jerome Woolsey coached here 24 years, and his winning percentage was above 50. He won over half his games. I think he won 367 games and lost like 340-some games. Man, there was like 20 games difference between his total wins and total losses. Did you know? Now, this is going to hurt. Every other coach, which we've not had that many because Jerome coached so many years, but you had Jack Kilday was the first. You got to throw in Jimmy Tunnel in there. And you've got Bert Starnes coached in there at some point. And then I think Jerome took it. Jerome was maybe the fourth coach. I may be wrong. Then you get into... David McLean, Arnold Loftus coached right after Coach Woolsey. So it went from Arnold, who helps Sam now, David McLean. There was a couple guys that just pulled 1 year apiece, Todd Baldwin, Jason Shelton. We brought in Ted Hensley, who pulled 5 years, who was a phenomenal coach. Brandon Broyles, who...
up at Unicoi County.
Yeah, he's at Unicoi, doing a great job with the girls now. He pulled 5 good years here, and he took them from, I mean, Ted built them up.
Yeah.
And then he left it in a good place. And then Brandon, you know, kept it right there, competitive, batting around 500, you know, winning about half. And then by his last 5th year, we
I
won
think
like
they
a,
had 2 years, like a 19 and then
yeah,
a 27.
But that last one, they broke through and won the first district championship in like 30 years. So, and then Brandon moved on and we brought in Sam, but all those other guys, their win percentage is below 500. They lost more than they won. And you can blame that on a lot of things. It sure was not coaching, because those guys worked hard and did the best they could. Sometimes it was talent. Sometimes it was just the sheer fact that we played in a loaded conference. I mean, you had a UNACA state champion in there in the early 2000s.
Clallam's good.
Hampton, who's a perennial powerhouse. A lot of people don't know Ned Smith, who's at Hampton now, coached at Clallam and took them to state tournaments before he flipped and went to Hampton. He helped Jerry White. You know, if you go to Hampton, it says Jerry White Gymnasium, or his name's on the court. All right, Ned helped him for a couple years before they gave him the head coaching job. So, I mean, just phenomenal teams. Everybody knows how good University High is year in and year out. So, playing against really hard teams, I think, was part of the reason. But then here comes Sam.
Yeah, I haven't had a good player. So
it's like everything the man's touched just turns to gold. He's the gold standard.
I don't know about that.
I bet his win percentage, and I ain't got it right here in front of me.
I think it's 157-57.
That's like Philip Fulmer. He was 151-51 or something like that.
I think I'm right at 100 over.
What is that, like 70%, 60-some, 70?
What does that add up to?
Well, you got like 200 games. Let's do some math here.
I think that's right.
214 games.
Maybe.
I don't know. I got all these messages on here. I'm OCD, man. I got clear stuff. I can't have stuff lingering. All right. What did we say? What's 157 plus how many losses?
57.
157, 57? That's 214. So what you do is you take them 50, or them,
math,
you multiply that by the wins. What is it?
157.
No, that ain't right. Hold up. How do you do that, Tyler? Come on, we're live.
Do 157.
Yeah, 157.
Divided by
the total number of games. That away. 73%.
There we go.
Find a coach anywhere around Greene County, Greenville City. Find them, Tyler. I want you to tell me who they are.
All right.
A better win percentage. Minimum.
5 years.
Four. We'll give them four. That way they cycle through a whole 100 class.
100 games.
Minimum 100 games.
Okay,
don't find somebody
that's four.
That went 25-4 for 1 year and left.
Okay.
Don't do that.
Minimum four. I'll do my homework.
Well, about to start basketball season. We're going to take a break, come back, talk about basketball.
You'll talk about the offseason first?
You're the host.
Yep.
You tell us what we're doing.
Take us through your offseason. Camps, practices.
Well, graduated four. Brought in four, so we're right back at nine.
Nasty nine.
The Nasty Nine 2.0. And then we go to FCA camp. Larry Bible always sends us to FCA camp. What an experience. Them kids get to get preached at, sung to. Them huddle leaders get them in there and work them, build up that spirit. We get in there and play some games. We had a couple of injuries. I know that's shocking to you. We had some injuries. We played eight games at that camp. And the first four games we played, we had out of those nine that I was talking about, we didn't have one of them during the summer. She's a foreign exchange student. So we only had eight during the summer. And we literally had two people go down at this camp. So the last four games we played, we had six. So there's that. Then we healed up a little bit, just a couple turned ankles, and we host a camp in there at Eastview. We have for years now, team camp, and a lot of schools came. We had about 26, 27 schools again this year, and we played some there as well. And then we went back to Middle Tennessee and played some games down there. Still not enough for a JV. I think I've looked ahead at our middle school, and there's good numbers there. So hopefully we'll get it built back up. I'm hoping next year we'll be around 15, 16 kids. I won't know what to do with a gym full of kids like that. But it was a fairly good summer. We were able to see what we need to work on and maybe some things we need to try to scrap and start over. We were able to build up a little experience and some cohesiveness. So I think overall it was a good summer. to Sam?
I'm trying to think where we went. Larry let us go to the FCA camp. That's for the first time.
Larry legend.
I think the kids really enjoyed it. We got to play some good teams while we were down there. I like that part of it. We did the same thing he did as far as Butch let us do a little team camp in there at the rec. Then we about died when we went to Wake Forest.
Is that the bus trip?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Had a good... Yeah, it was raining.
Do you want to speak to that on camera?
It rained hard and our bus driver didn't slow down. I thought I was dead two or three times. And her GPS kept messing up.
Mm.
So we about got lost. But no, we had really a lot of fun on that trip.
Trivia for Tyler, head coach at Wake Forest.
Steve Forbes.
Hey, he knows he's college basketball.
Come on, man. I went to ETSU when he was there.
Okay.
The golden days of ETSU.
Just making sure you knew.
It's the best Buccaneer team ever.
I thought we...
What?
That's the best Buccaneer team ever.
Well, that's right. You wasn't alive when the real Buccaneer team from the early 90s.
What are you talking about?
With the...
Marty Story, Calvin Taufer, Keith Jennings. Yep, I know who you're talking about.
You think that's better now?
Mm-hmm. Only 30-win team ever.
I think, actually, are you talking about the ones that went to the tournament?
The ones that were scheduled to go to the tournament and the tournament got canceled.
Now, I think they might have been a little bit better a couple years before that.
Did you say Mr.
The one
James?
That made it and lost to Florida?
The one with when they had Cromer and all that. I think they were a little better then.
You said Keith, Mr.
That
James,
was
Greg Dennis.
Dennis, that was another one.
Did you say them?
Dennis.
They're the
Dennis.
Best two, Mr. Jennings and Greg Dennis.
Missed on Dennis.
How do you get them? Go ahead, boys.
I think that was
they were a little
when
better
I was a senior in high school. A
couple years before that, in my opinion.
They had.
You're talking about the team with Pat Good and them.
Pat Good, yeah. Isaiah.
I'm talking about two.
Trey Boy.
I'm talking about 2 years before that. I think they were a little better.
They had DeSante Bradford.
He was on both those teams.
Yeah.
DeSante
wasn't on that segment.
Well, he's a single A product. Didn't know that, did you?
DeSante?
Single A.
Didn't.
Single A.
Hey, turn the power off on this thing.
How's about power?
Yeah.
Take him through it.
What do you mean? If he quit two buttons somewhere.
Sometimes
I don't ever turn it off.
I get these messages. Look, everything's clear. I don't have any outstanding messages, but it's showing that stupid, that red circle.
Yeah,
well, I can't handle it.
I hate it too. Quick
so
on.
I have to turn. Well, I do. It's gone. I mean, okay. There's nothing unread. And you know what happens?
I don't
people
know.
Will do one heart things or.
They'll like it.
Emoji.
Yeah.
Oh, no. Oh, I see what you're saying. The clicks.
Yeah, and it don't show up as a. It shows up here.
But it don't show up
But
on
I've already deleted the thread.
Oh.
And now, so how do you turn the power off?
Two buttons, yep.
There it is.
Oh, but...
If you turn it off and turn it back on, it goes away.
Nice.
We played pretty well. I got most of my kids returning. Kind of cut our teeth last year. So we had probably the best summer wins and loss, for sure, of any team that I've had since I've been here. So I don't know what
I'm
that's
going to do. I'm going to make a prediction.
No, don't do that,
I'm
coach.
Do it.
Don't do it.
Take us into the break.
Can I do it?
Hey, right. You do whatever you want.
You ready?
Don't get too crazy with it.
You don't want me to?
I want it. I want it. I love
State
it.
State champs!
Oh, gosh.
You want me to clear it up? You want me to justify it?
Yeah.
You know who won it last year? Hampton. Look at their postseason. They played one really difficult game that they almost lost. The rest of their postseason games, they controlled them all. Well, I mean, they lost in the district and regional championship to University High. Keep that in your mind.
Mm-hmm.
So they dodge UH in the state tournament because they're on opposite sides of the bracket. The team that eliminates UH, Hampton beats. All right, now let's do some simple math here. Hampton moved 2A.
Yep.
This team that they beat for the championship, I don't even know who it was. Who was it, Middleton?
Yeah, they lost their...
Yeah, they had a Mr. Basketball Finals that graduated. Bye-bye. They're out. So you know what? I think we're going to play UH five times this year. Twice in the season. We're going to play them in the district championship.
Region
Sorry,
championship.
Cloud and Unique. I'm just guessing here. Region championship, that's four.
And then state and championship or somewhere in there?
State championship. No, it'd have to be in a championship because they put you in opposite sides of the bracket if you're in the same district.
I think there's a few teams that might have something to say about that.
I'm sure they do, but those teams probably don't watch this show. We're going to play them five times.
I take that right now. I take it.
I'm calling it right now.
Coach has been in one of them championship games. I got to get there.
Just don't do what I do when you get there. Blow it in overtime. Does that take us to the break?
That'll take us to the break. Predicts,
we should have waited so they come back. Come back after the break. I got another prediction.
All right. We'll go ahead and
don't go anywhere.
We'll be right back after these messages.
My name is Robert Starnes. I'm a lifelong resident of Northern Greene County, where I currently reside here with my wife and three children. I was a barber in Greenville for the last 6 years, but I have recently changed locations to my new shop in Baileyton. It's at 285 Mortis Hollow Lane, Afton. I'm also a proud supporter of North Greene Athletics. Come see me for all of your men and boys' grooming needs. Go Huskies!
Baileyton Drug Company services the surrounding communities of Baileyton with excellent patient care using a full-line pharmacy, over-the-counter selections, and a convenient drive-thru. When you visit us, you are treated as a neighbor, not a number. It's not just our slogan, but our culture. We're invested in our patients, local schools, and community. For over 5 years now, we have established ourselves as an independently family-run pharmacy that isn't driven by corporate goals. We are driven by what is best for your overall health and wellness. We are conveniently located so you don't have to make the drive. Prescription drugs are just the tip of the iceberg. We also offer natural remedies, essential oils, at-home medical needs, such as walkers, rollators, bath accessories, as well as wound care products. And coming soon, basic urgent care services. What makes us better than other drug stores out there? When you frequent Baileyton Drug, you will receive professional, courteous, and friendly service that goes above and beyond any other pharmacy in the area. Remember, you're a neighbor, not a number.
Welcome back to this week's edition of the Baileyton Drug Company TMB Show, presented by Starne's Barbershop. As always, I'm joined here with Huskies head coach Sam Tarlton and Lady Huskies head coach
different?
James McKinnon.
That's different.
It's different.
Okay.
I switched it up a little bit.
What is
it? Used to
who
be the,
used to be? T.A.?
Can't say it now.
Yeah, you can say it.
Oh, we can say it.
T.A.
T.A.
Davy Crockett Travel Center.
We still,
it was the Davy Crockett Travel Center, James Buchanan, and Sam Tarlton, TMB, BNT, whatever.
Did they, let me ask you, this may be too personal. You may not want to answer this question. Did you ask them again?
I don't know.
And they just said,
no, we ain't sponsoring them two idiots. Call Dalton. I don't know.
Okay. All right.
I don't do anything with
it's
business.
Probably better that we don't know. Because I still go there. I go
me
to
too,
IHOP.
Me too. It's a good place to
they
go.
Sponsor the school.
Okay. That's good.
See, they love us. They're right here close. Baileyton is where it's at. You think you're special because you're getting a Texas Roadhouse? We've got an IHOP. We go to IHOP after our games.
Tell
after we get a barber shop visit before the game.
That's right.
And then when we're sick, we go to the drugstore.
Got it. Plug
the other
ones. We're plugging them.
Somebody's got to plug Tommy Plum and don't they give you a
Tommy's plumbing. They're somewhere on here right now.
Tommy's plumbing.
Their Tommy's plumbing is everywhere I turn. They're
yep.
Tommy's.
Yeah, you seen, see the van.
Did you see the... At the rec, they're on the scoreboard now. Tommy's Plumbing.
The new volleyball courts at Hardin Park. They're on the scoreboards there, too. Not volleyball courts, I guess. Little sand pits, whatever. I don't know what you call them.
Okay. You ready for my other prediction?
Go for it.
Or should we do a cliffhanger?
Do you have a prediction, too?
And make them wait to the
end
of the season.
I know what
it
is.
Okay.
No, this has nothing to do with
this.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I got one.
Is this 5 straight years you're going to go state tournament coach?
Don't do it.
Yeah.
Don't do it. To
coach
us.
Is going back 5 times.
Woo! Remember Booker T? 5 times. I don't. Hey, cut that
no,
out.
No, that's going.
No, that's staying.
Going
we
in.
Can't
that's
do it to these kids. Don't put that on them.
No.
That's all right.
Coach, you just said I was going to state championship.
Okay, that's fair. That's fair.
Yeah, that stays.
Hey, we're going to give it our best shot. I guarantee you this.
By February, March, he'll have him right in the thick of it.
Absolutely. We spoke about it last week when I came in here.
Buddy.
I don't know if we want to go over the scenarios
we're
on
crazy.
Here, but I mean.
It might be 22 to 20. He'll
yeah,
have a minute.
Do whatever it takes.
He'll have a minute.
Hey, it was a 40 to 39 sub-state game last year.
Hey, that's my favorite photograph, maybe of all time, is that team picture. They're all soaking wet, sweaty, messed up, her hair's all over the place. They're grinning from ear to ear, tickled, half dead. I'm not in the picture, which makes it even better. And right behind them is the scoreboard where we held that team 39 on their home floor.
That's a good picture.
So
that's awesome, man.
Yeah.
Yes.
I have a video of that, too, if you want me to send it to
a lot
you.
Of members, yeah.
Of her walking off court.
Yeah, I'd like to see that.
I was there getting highlighted.
Grace is helping me.
Yeah.
Hey, here's a weird one. As I'm sitting here, doing the show, I get a text from Sonya Wagner. Says, good luck tonight. And she sent it to me and Grace. And it was neat because she called us both coaches. Grace is on the coaching staff now. We can't get enough.
Yet.
Huh?
Does it feel weird yet?
No. It's like nothing's changed, really, except she ain't in uniform. Because, it's just, she's been around it since she's little. Just keep it rolling.
Is Richard back this year?
Richard is. He quit. He retired.
There comes a time.
Yeah, there comes a time. He's my coach. He's my personal coach. He makes sure
he may be back next year.
Yeah.
You never know, Richard.
He took a year off, didn't he?
Yeah.
He just
my first year he wasn't there, but he was here last year.
He's made a request.
That's the kind of coaching job I want.
He made a request last night. When I went by his house last night, he requested to be taken off the sign.
We got
to
take him off the sign. Well, we ain't going to get it done today, Richard. This is opening day. We ain't getting the ladder out right now. We got
you telling me. So when he comes in here today, fussing at me,
we tip it up in an hour and 20 minutes.
I'm gonna send him right to your
4 o'clock Cedar View Seahawks.
Well, since we're right into it, go ahead and take me. You got a thick
my other prediction. We still didn't do it.
Are you gonna do it at the end of the show? Make him watch.
I'll call right now. Jason Britton, Mr. Basketball.
Okay.
You had
that one might be the most likely out of all.
Well, out of the three finalists last year, two of them graduated.
Yeah.
So.
Was it leading in the clubhouse? Probably. It got to be. They'll find some way to.
They'll give it to somebody that don't deserve it. Yeah. No, I'm just kidding. They don't get it. Well, I'll tell you what's crazy about that award. First of all, it's great if you ever get recognized as being a finalist. But look at who votes on that. Look at who decides that. And I'll tell you what we need. And I ain't going to do a Sean Jones right now. I'm not going to do that. But your local media really has to push. And I'm not just talking about Greenville Sun, Grassroots. We need Johnson City. We need Morristown. We need Knoxville. And if you look, that metro Nashville area, those guys from the middle part of the state, a lot of times, and it's sad that it's like this, but, I mean, there is a board that selects that winner, and that board is getting their information from media outlets and some coaches. I would say the coaching vote plays a big role in it if it's a landslide.
Mm-hmm.
If, like, a bunch of coaches say, yeah, this kid's got to get it, that's probably who that board picks. But if it's kind of close, and, Sam worked his tail end off last year trying to get Jason's name out there and getting all the local coaches to nominate him, you know. But at the end of the day, that board picks it. And you just got to see where them board members are from. The selection committee or something like that. And I'll say this, if anybody from East Tennessee wins it, you've really done something. Because I don't know that we've had one outside of Gillespie. Kobe. And that was a no-brainer.
Well, he probably was a no-brainer the year before that too, and he didn't win it, right? Or did he win it twice?
Did they? No, he won it once. Did they do one that year?
They did. Because the boy from Bolivar won it, and he gave him.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. It was back to back.
Yeah.
Yeah. I was thinking COVID the year before. Because
I remember it was a big deal. They were saying that one boy's going to win it, and they were matching up. And, I mean, they just blew him out of the water.
Yeah. So, that's my other prediction.
All right. We got another one about Saturday.
When's this going to air?
Probably later this week, before Saturday.
You heard it here first. All you naysayers, the ones that, you know how, here it is, let me get real candid here with the folks watching. I've lived this my whole life. Philip Fulmer would win a big game, and then he'd lose a couple, and everybody's ready to fire him. And somehow, some way, I'll never forget this, we lost an early season game to, like, Florida. Everybody's wrote the man off. This would be in the early 2000s. Go back, look it up. We were supposed to play LSU that coming Saturday, and there was a hurricane. So we didn't play them on Saturday. The game got moved to a Monday night. If you'll check your history books, there was a Monday night football game with Tennessee playing LSU in Baton Rouge, Death Valley. Nobody gave us a shot. Nobody. We wasn't supposed to win, but the spirit of the Volunteers. You don't ever look at what we done last week and that determines what we're going to do this week unless Butch Jones or Jeremy Pruitt or Derek Dooley's coaching. Because that, you know, we ain't counting that. I believe in this man. We took a hit. They smacked us around. We might have overlooked them. I don't know. I don't know what the narrative is. Missouri got us. A lot of people done give up. It's basketball season. Basketball team's going to be good this year.
We're going to be, I think we got a chance at it.
And that's great. You know, that's great. But you heard it here first. Dogs going down. On Rocky Top. Go ahead and put your comments. Do they do that still? Go ahead and tell me how crazy
What's the score, Coach?
What I don't know.
We're just going to find a way. New teacher?
Mm-hmm.
DJ Sweeney. The first week. We asked him, you know, give us a score prediction, and he guessed it right on the money.
Right on the money.
Which one?
It was our game against, like, Virginia. Austin Peay. No, it was Virginia. Yeah, he nailed it.
Opening game.
Yeah, he nailed it.
I about got the Connecticut game. I said 56-3. I think we beat him 59-3. Hey, just post your comments. I'm an idiot. I don't know anything. Tennessee's got no chance. Georgia's going to kill them. They might do it.
No.
But I got a feeling. I may be here next week saying, don't ever ask me anything about college football.
It's going to go one of two ways. We're going to be in it, and I think Grant will win it. If not, they're going to blow us out.
Yeah, it'd be
this
like
This is an exciting year for college football, though.
They're probably feeling real good about themselves, though. They're just hammered.
I've seen where your boy's coming back.
There are eight teams.
Who you like, still, Texas?
Your quarterback's coming back.
He's here. He played against TCU last week.
I'm talking about he's coming back next year.
Oh, yeah. There's rumors that he's coming back his junior year.
So is Manning hitting the portal?
No, he stays.
There's another guy ahead of Manning, though, isn't there?
Yeah, Malik. But
so you're a five-star, top recruit in the nation, supposedly, and you got to wait till you're a junior before you can play?
Well, didn't Eli stay like 3 years before he got started?
I don't know.
He's going to go to Texas A&M.
Who, Arch?
Yeah.
Who's going to coach Texas A&M?
Deion Sanders.
I don't know. I love it all, though.
Hey, bring it. Hit my theme
you
music.
You don't want Deion coaching against your boys.
A&M?
Okay. All right, here's your good question, Tyler. I want you to ask every coach that you do a show with. How many coaches do you do a show with now?
Eight
coaches. You do them all? All county?
All county.
Basketball? All right, ask them all. If they were able to walk into a practice or a pregame speech and before they hit the court, hit my theme music like Dion, I want to know what song plays.
Okay. That'll be a little segment.
Yeah.
That'll be good.
So you just gave us the idea. So we'll do a little segment.
We already have theme music, I guess, don't we?
Well, let's do it this way. That's the show.
Can we reveal it next week?
Yeah, we need to think on it.
All right.
The show, it needs to be a song that what's it do? Does it just describe us or it just fits?
Okay.
Our theme music.
All right.
I got to come up.
That'll be a little segment. We'll have a little minute. YouTube short.
See,
later in the year.
Swing Low, Sweet Chariot.
Don't reveal it too much.
Okay.
But speaking of basketball,
we're gonna have to talk about.
Like you mentioned,
we're gonna talk.
You're tipping off in 1:15. You got three schools coming in tonight.
Yep.
Take us through it.
Okay. I play two. Sam plays two. Mm-hmm. First of all, to cut down on confusion, we both play Cedarview. I'm at 4. He's at whenever we get done. All right. Then I got Happy Valley's girls coming in. He's got Tennessee High's boys. And as far as scheduling goes, sometimes you try to get... Oh, no.
No.
It's time for the after.
It's time for the announcements. Welcome back. We had two breaks. You don't know this, but part of this got cut out. We had our afternoon announcements. All right, so we got... You try to call schools and schedule girls and boys. Sometimes that don't work. People have plans as far as what they do for Hall of Champions games. So, you know, this year we were able to find, and I really, just to be honest with you folks, I really didn't want to play a lot of nights where we got two games in one day just because we don't have that many players.
Mm-hmm.
But this presented itself. We had this option. We do play two games in one day at summer camps and sometimes in scrimmages. We had a scrimmage last week with Unicoi County and Johnson County. So we played, and then we rested, and then we played. So it'll be very similar to what we do tonight. hopefully we'll survive that. And then on Thursday, we're just playing Jellicoe. Now, he's got Jellicoe and Dobbins Bennett.
Yep.
So that's our schedule this week.
And then next week, I don't know if you want to go too far into it yet because we'll come in here early next week and talk, but you go straight into your Thanksgiving tournaments too. Yep. I know you're in the Hardest Classic once again, which you were in last year. And then you're in a new one this year also. Previously, you've been in the Thanksgiving Classic.
At Sullivan East, yeah. Just, you know, they had a coaching change at Sullivan East. And, you know, I'm weird. I try to have our schedule set pretty much before this season ends. Our schedule next year will be getting close to finished. And I'm just OCD. I try to get stuff done early. So it's March, and they've had a coaching change. They've not named a new coach, so I didn't know if they were going to continue having it or what the deal was. And so, you know, Granger has one, Coach Bishop down there, good friend of mine, and his brother coaches at Washburn. They always come to my team camps, and I thought, you know, I'm going to go down there and try theirs out at Granger. So not that Sullivan East did a bad job. That's a good tournament. And we may go back at some point. I have no idea. Who knows what we'll do. But we are at Granger, and Sam's at Crockett.
Take us through your opponents that you'll see in that.
Oh, the first day is Cumberland Gap, and then the second day is Knox Central, and then the third day is Granger.
Okay, so you got some pretty good competition up there.
Tell you what's weird, I thought maybe I could find some film on Jellicoe and Cumberland Gap. I thought maybe they play Hall of Champions games. I think we are their first game, both those schools, so I'll have no film on them.
Really? So Cumberland Gap's not playing any games until they play them?
It's kind of like tonight's games. You're watching film from last year. Just trying to refresh your memory on these teams, and you're getting film from Happy Valley, from some teams that they played late last season, knowing that there's kids on the film that aren't there no more, and you don't know who they've replaced them with. You're hoping that maybe the style is similar. I did try to make it a point during the summer if I'd see them at camp. You know, some of the schools that we would be playing early in the year, I tried to kind of watch them to make a few notes and be somewhat prepared, but that's the part I hate early in the season is sometimes you feel like you're not very well prepared. But we're going to play it anyway. And you know what I figured out?
What's that?
And you can ask Brad Woolsey this because he's proved this. We're going to use a rock line right here. Tyler, what do you think about basketball games in November and December?
What do I
think? It doesn't matter what you think of November, December don't matter. I mean, Brad loses all kinds of games November, December, waiting on them football kids to show up. And then he wins two state titles.
Probably should have been three.
And you look at the win-loss record.
Drivers and car riders can be dismissed.
Their win-loss record might not be what he wanted because they lose some games early.
Who cares?
But what does that matter?
Nope. All that matters is what you're doing in March.
I'm glad they don't matter because ours, we've loaded down here before Christmas.
He's bulked it up.
Take us through yours, because I know what he just said where you've got Tennessee High and Dobbins Bennett coming
High
up.
And Dobbins Bennett.
Then you got the Hardest Classic, which is always
Jellicoe's good.
Jellicoe's good, yeah.
Yeah. Jellicoe was a good game last year.
Yeah. So that's,
that was honestly what could have potentially been a nominee for best game.
That was a good game.
That was a great game last year.
Yeah. I don't like that place going there. That's a good place.
That was a fun atmosphere, I will say. Yeah. If that's the only time I ever go to Jellicoe, it was a treat.
I've been there twice. And
hey, if you ever go to Jellicoe, got to eat at the pizza spot.
Is it good?
It's a great place.
Never heard of it. Yeah. I almost got locked in that night. Did I tell you about that?
Mm-mm.
I stayed in the parking lot to write my story that night, the article.
And they locked the gate on you?
And I happened to just look over, and they locked the gate on me. Luckily, the opposite gate was left open.
Mm.
So I got lucky. I was one of the only, like, two or three cars left in the parking lot.
That'd been tough. No, they're good. Tennessee High has a chance to win that league. That'll be a tough test tonight.
They're 3A now, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dobbins Bennett.
4A.
You know what they are.
They won a state title here a couple years ago,
then
right?
Then we got Daniel Boone, the first round of the Hardys.
Wow.
Then South Green's in there with us, South Green and Providence. You also got Crockett, Unicoi, Chucky Doe, all them's in there. We played two county schools on the road before Christmas, I think, Coach. I think Sullivan East is in there somewhere.
Hey, right after Thanksgiving, whoever makes a schedule around here.
We got three road games.
We got three games in 1 week, and they're all on the road. It's like Hancock, West Green, South Green.
Yeah.
Road. Who did that?
He's going to woke us up on home games.
We're stupid.
You had a lot of home games.
I was thinking about that today.
Was it opposite last year? You had a lot of home games.
We had a lot of home games early last year.
The JVs, their first game's going to be at Hancock.
Is that right?
Yeah.
That'll be tough. Get to drive a long way.
Is the first one I hear
you're doing banjos.
Tuesday and then West Greene and Thursday.
No, I'm hoping I get it this year, though.
What do you mean you get it?
Can't you request?
I can request. I probably
been there so long where you pick your schedule.
We can't talk about Hancock now. Golly.
No, we're not talking about it yet.
Yeah,
we're just talking about
forever from now.
We're just talking about the banjos, the entrance.
All right.
Coach, I think that's all we got.
Coach, you got to go.
Yep, we got to go. Fellas.
Golly, thank you guys for tuning in.
We first started, so apologize for that.
Sam.
We'll go week two next week. Anything special next week? Did you say you had something next week or no?
What?
Oh, yeah, you got to think of your music.
Yeah, we got to think of our
theme. Give me my theme.
Yeah.
Anything else scheduled next week?
Boom, boom.
It's a... Oh, next week? No, I was thinking of his theme music. Dion's is something by Mystical, one of these kids says.
See, I don't even know these people. Mystical.
We need to assume we're going to be doing college football playoff and New Year's Six again.
We'll pick it.
That'll probably be...
What'd I win? I won something last year.
I think you won our bracket challenge. Out of the three of us, you won the bracket challenge. Okay.
Go Big Orange.
I think Dallas, Malone, and Drew were top two in the bracket challenge. Out of the whole grassroots one. Out of us three, it was you. We were cellar dwellers.
Yeah.
I had a rough second weekend. But that's it. You got tip off in an hour. Got a fun night here in North Greene. Thank you all for watching this week's edition of the Baileyton Drug Company TMB Show, presented by Starne's Barbershop. Look forward to seeing you next time here on Grassroots Media.
Welcome back, Season 3.